ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and jazakumullah khair for tuning in to this week's first episode of Children's Storytime, continuing our series about the 10 companions that were given the glad tidings of Jannah. And now coming to the end of them, we only have two left. Today we're going to speak about the great Sahabi and companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and one of the first to accept Islam in Mecca, Saeed ibn Zaid radiyallahu ta'ala anhu wa ardah. Saeed ibn Zaid was a very great Sahabi. Saeed ibn Zaid radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was one of the first to accept Islam. He was married to Fatima, the sister of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu. And in a very famous story, Umar ibn al-Khattab, who was very harsh before he accepted Islam in Mecca, he was very harsh against the Muslimin. So whenever he heard that someone accepted Islam and left idol worship, Umar would go and beat them up. So one day he comes in and he finds a Quran, part of the Mus'haf, or one of the surahs, written on whatever they used to write on that time, and he found them reciting, and he found out that his sister Fatima and her husband Saeed accepted Islam. So Umar ibn al-Khattab went, and you know, it's a long story, inshallah, because today we're talking about Saeed ibn Zaid. We don't want to go through the whole story, but basically Saeed ibn Zaid was one of the reasons that Umar ibn al-Khattab accepted Islam, because he told him to read the Quran. Umar read the Quran, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened his heart to it. And then he went to the Prophet ﷺ and accepted Islam. So imagine this, all of the good deeds of Umar would go in the scale of Saeed ibn Zaid radiyallahu ta'ala anhu arda. Saeed ibn Zaid was also mustajabu da'wah. He was also, like, his dua was answered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all his duas. And this was because of his closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his taqwa. In an incident that happened between him and a lady whose name was Arwa bint Aws. In this story, they went to Marwan ibn al-Hakam, and this was way after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Khulafa al-Rashideen, because he lived a long time after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He went to Marwan ibn al-Hakam, who was the leader at that time, and a woman claimed that some of his land was hers. She said, "That's my land, and Saeed ibn Zaid is taking it from me, and he's claiming that it's his." So Saeed ibn Zaid, he told Marwan, "Listen, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam say that whoever steals a piece of land that isn't his, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will surround them with it on the Day of Judgment in 7 different folds, one for each of the levels of the heavens, subhanallah. So basically, they will be surrounded by this land and punished with it. So stealing land is haram and one of the worst things, subhanallah." And he narrated this hadith. So Marwan ibn al-Hakam, who was the leader then, said, "That's it. You don't even need a proof. I accept this from you, ya Saeed ibn Zaid." And the woman said, no, but he's taking my land." So Saeed ibn Zaid made dua against her. He said, "Oh Allah, if she is lying, then take her sight away and make her die in her own land." And this woman lived a long time after, and she became blind, subhanallah, and she would walk around around the village and say, the dua of Saeed ibn Zaid was answered against me. The dua of Saeed ibn Zaid was answered, and she was blind, and guess what? She tripped in a hole, in like there's a pit in her land, and she fell inside it, and she died as well. So the dua of Saeed ibn Zaid was answered. And in a famous incident, Saeed ibn Zaid radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was doing haras, which or ribat. Basically, he was watching the Muslimin at night so that none of the enemies come and attack them at night. Saeed ibn Zaid was there and he was very tired. He didn't sleep for days. So another Sahabi told Saeed ibn Zaid, how about you go to sleep and I watch for you? Just rest for a bit. So Saeed ibn Zaid said, okay. He went to rest for a bit, and then he was dreaming and seeing things. And he was saying stuff. So his companion, who was still awake, he was hearing him. He's like, what is he talking about? What is he talking about? SubhanAllah. And then he woke him up. He's like, yeah, Saeed, wake up, wake up. So Saeed woke up. He's like, why did you wake me up? Why did you wake me up? He said, well, you were saying stuff. He was saying marhaba. He was saying welcome. Welcome to, a'udhu billahi ash-shaytan ar-rajim. He was saying welcome to a certain person, a name of a woman. And Saeed ibn Zaid told his companion, why did you wake me up? He said, because I was dreaming that I was in Yawm al-Qiyamah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told me to enter Jannah. And as I entered Jannah, and this is Saeed ibn Zaid saying his dream, he said, as I entered Jannah, the doors opened and I saw many beautiful creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Beautiful, from the Hur al-Ain. And I said, who are these? He said, they're so beautiful, who are these? He said, oh, these are just your servants in Jannah. They serve you and they bring you whatever you want in Jannah. Subhanallah. Then he said, I entered and I saw three Hur al-Ain, and one of them looked like the sun from how beautiful she was. And she said, I am your zawja from the Hur al-Ain. And he said, marhaban. And he extended his hand to shake her hand, and she said, no, I'm haram for you today. I cannot touch you. But in three, you will be halal for me. And then he was woken up. So he woke up and he told him, why did you wake me up? Inshallah, in three. I don't know three what, but in three I'm going to be united in Jannah with my Hur al-Ain. And after 3 days, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed that he died and he was martyred, radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa ardah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite us with him in Jannah. Yet another Sahabi that we couldn't go into his life extensively, but they lived great lives. He participated in so many futuhat and so many openings. And there are so many things that you can learn about Saeed ibn Zaid. If you go search about him on your personal time, inshallah ta'ala, read about him. There are so many lectures online about these the 10 Sahabis that were given the glad tidings of Jannah. Go back and search, inshallah. This is just a little dose of their lives, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to benefit from it. Jazakumullah khair, and thank you for tuning in. And stay tuned tomorrow for the last Sahabi, Abdurrahman ibn Auf, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. See you tomorrow, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.
إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات والصادقين والصادقات والصابرين والصابرات والخاشعين والخاشعات والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما.